بسم
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على رسوله الكريم أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Now we've moved on to today, verse 13, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is still making mention regarding the hypocrites, and this will go all the way on to, I think we've got about 7 more verses covering the hypocrites. And now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَإِذَا قِيلَ لَهُمْ آمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ النَّاسِ. And when it is said to them that believe like the people have believed. So who is this firstly talking about? When it mentions how the people have believed, is talking about the Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So remember, the hypocrites openly, they claim to be Muslims. So these are people who openly, they're saying that we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we believe in the articles of faith, the angels, the books, the previous prophets, and so on and so forth. So it's being said to them, believe like the companions. So one thing is, of course, to firmly establish your belief in these articles of faith and everything that comes with it. And also remember, at that time, you had the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in their presence. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam would give guidance to the companions. For example, there are many narrations where the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Man kana yu'minu billahi wal yawm al-akhir, فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوَلْ يَسْمُتْ." There are many narrations where the Prophet ﷺ said, whomsoever believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day. So the word believe is used. Whomsoever believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day should say good or remain quiet. Or there are other narrations, whomsoever believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day, then do not cause harm to your neighbors. And there are many narrations like this. So when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was giving this guidance to the companions, they embraced it fully. However, the hypocrites, they didn't embrace it fully. They may have embraced it for show, but the reality of their actions and what their actions were actually showing to the people is that they have not actually embraced this. They have not brought full belief into this. They are still causing discord between the believers. They are still doing things like backbiting, spreading gossip. People are saying to them, believe like the companions, believe like the Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, believe like the Umar radiallahu anhu, and believe like the companions. And what did they say? قَالُوا أَنُؤْمِنُوا كَمَا آمَنَ السُّفَهَا. They said, should we believe like the foolish people have believed? So these hypocrites, they believed, they deemed the believers to be foolish people. Now, let's remember the situation. So you had the people of Makkah who've migrated to Medina. So when they've migrated, they've had to leave everything behind. They've left their homes, they've left a large portion of their wealth. So they've come to Medina and they don't really have much. So when the hypocrites were looking at the people of Makkah, because these were people who they love the dunya. Yeah, they love wealth, they love status, they love all of these things, to be famous and all of these things. So when they're looking at the Sahaba, the companions, they're thinking, these people, they've left their wealth, they've left, you know, they've left their tribes where they had all of this security, where they had this status. So they are looking at the companions from Makkah as what they deem Sufaha. And then they're also looking at the people of Medina in a similar way, because they are thinking, these people now are sharing their wealth. So the people of Medina, they were sharing their wealth, they were sharing their homes with the people of Makkah. And not only that, but you also had some of the companions, or maybe even many of the companions, who were poor people. For example, you had some who previously they were slaves and now they've embraced Islam. So they're looking at these people and thinking, you know, these people, they're quite lowly in status, and we don't want to be on the same footing as them. We're a separate class to them. So the munafiqun, they saw these people as people who, the word which we can think of is streetwise. Yeah, streetwise, where a person, you know, like a child, because this word sufaha as derivative is also used for children. A child, he may know something, but he doesn't have a full understanding of it. So how things work in the real world, like we say, how things work on the street or in the business world, you have to have an understanding of how these things work. So these people, the hypocrites, this is how they deemed the companions. They felt that they don't really have a good grasp or a good understanding of how things work. And that is why they are, they may be poor, or they may, you know, they may be looked down on in society. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clarifies, no, in reality, you people are the sufaha. Yeah, you people are the sufaha. You people are the ones who do not understand. Yeah, this world is extremely short. You're only here for a short time, and you're trying to, firstly, you're lying, you're trying to deceive, you're doing all of these things, and you're doing it for something which is very temporary. After a few years, it's all going to go, and you're not going to have anything. So in reality, you people are the ones who are the sufaha. However, they do not know. So this just further, you know, further allowing us to understand the characteristics of the hypocrites. They didn't even realize. They didn't even realize how foolish they were. I just want to clarify also, previously where they mentioned that they believed that they were the reformers of society. Another of the reasons is because they weren't doing major things which we all would know, which we all would understand. For example, they weren't going around murdering people, they weren't robbing people, they weren't doing these type of things which would be clear cut to anyone, believer or non-believer. So they thought to themselves that, you know, we are not the mufsidun. We are not the people who cause corruption in the earth, because we're not doing these things. We're not killing anyone. We're not robbing anyone. We're not usurping people's land. So this is the hypocrites. And there's been so much emphasis Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is telling us about them, explaining to us their characteristics. And the scary part is, the really scary part is, and this is a question we have to ask ourselves, do I have any of these qualities? So I, as a believer, of course we don't fake our belief. We are true believers. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us on true belief and give us death upon iman. But do we have some of these characteristics? Do we look down at people because they don't have a high status? Do we look down at people because society looks down at them? Do we think to ourselves that, you know, I am someone special like Shaytan, who's deemed himself to be higher in status than man? And these hypocrites, they also deem themselves to be high. They don't want to be on the same par. They don't want to be on the same footing as the believers, those from amongst them who were maybe poorer. Do we have these qualities within ourselves? Do we think I am better? Do I think I am better because of my job title, because of my status in society, because of my country, because of my color? This is a question as believers that we have to ask ourselves. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us understanding and protect us from these qualities. Join me again tomorrow, Quran 365. Do subscribe to the channel and do click on the notification button. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.